So question number 15, fairly a lengthier question. Let us have patience to understand this. So there is a straight highway which leads to the foot of a tower. So there are two things here. There is a highway. Highway refers to a road. Let us call this as A and B. And there is a tower. So this highway leads to a tower. Let's call this as C. So this 90 degree. A man standing at the top of the tower. Let's say somebody is standing over here. Observes a car at an angle of depression of 30 degree. So from here, since the height of the man is not given, we assume that we ignore his height and angle of depression of a car. Let's say the car is at A. So this is 30 degree. So obviously this will be 30 degree because alternate interior angles. Which is approaching the foot of the tower with uniform speed. This car is traveling at uniform speed 6 seconds later. So this is, let us say this is at t equal to 0 seconds. 6 seconds later, angle of depression of the car is found to be 60 degree. So the car comes closer to the tower. So the car is somewhere here. So angle of depression is 60 degree and hence it is 60. Thus this will be 60 degree. We'll call this as D. This is at time 6 seconds. T equal to 6 seconds. Find the time taken by the car to reach the foot of the tower from this point. So we need to find how much time it takes for the car to reach B from D. So let us solve this. Quite a tricky question. Of course, there are two triangles here. Triangle ABC and triangle CDB. Now this distance, let us take X. And this is the distance covered by the car in 6 seconds. We know distance is equal to velocity into time. So thus distance covered AB is 6B. Because T is equal to 6 seconds. Now considering triangle ABC, we get tan 30 equal to, let's say the height of the tower is Y. Tan 30 equal to Y by AB, which is equal to, tan 30 is 1 by root 3. Y by AB is nothing but AD plus DB. So 1 by root 3 equal to Y by 6B plus X. Now let us move on with triangle CDB. Here tan 60 is equal to Y by X, which is nothing but root 3 equal to Y by X. So this is 1. Let us call this equation as 2. Now let us take 1 by 2 so that we can eliminate Y easily. So 1 by 2 will be equal to Y by 6B plus X by Y by X. Equal to 1 by root 3 by root 3. So this implies, so YY gets cancelled. So 1 by root 3 by root 3 will be equal to 1 by 3. x by 6v plus x equal to 1 by 3. So it is 3x equal to 6v plus x, or 2x equal to 6v, or x equal to 3 times of v. So x is the distance traveled, v is the velocity. So from x equal to 3v, we can observe few things. X is the distance traveled, v is the velocity. So obviously, then 3 is nothing but the time taken by the car to reach the distance x. Thus, the time taken by the car to reach the foot of the tower is nothing but 3 seconds. So the angle of elevation of top of a tower from two points at a distance of 4 meter and 9 meter from the base of the tower and in the same straight line with it are complementary. So the characters involved are a tower and two points at 4 meter, one at 4 meter and another at 9 meter from the base of the tower. So I have a tower here. So there are two points, one at 4 meter from the base of the tower and another at 9 meter from the base of the tower. So the angle of elevation, there is an angle. Let us call this as theta 1. So from this point we observe the top of the tower. Let's call this as theta 2. Angle of elevation of top of tower from two points are complementary in nature. In the sense, theta 1 plus theta 2 is equal to 90 degrees. So we need to prove that height of the tower is 6 meter. So how could we do that? So let us first name this triangle. So let us say this is A, this is B, C and D. So currently let us assume AB is equal to H. We need to prove that H equal to 6 meter. Now tan of theta 1 is equal to H by 4, that is opposite by adjacent. Similarly, tan of theta 2 from triangle ABD, it is equal to H by 9 meters. However, theta 1 and theta 2 are complementary in nature. Therefore, tan of theta 2 is nothing but tan of 90 minus theta 1, which is equal to H by 9. So tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta. So obviously we can write this as cot theta 1 equal to H by 9. So we have tan theta 1 equal to H by 4 and cot theta 1 equal to H by 9. So multiplying LHS and RHS, we get tan theta 1 into cot theta 1 equal to H by 4 into H by 9. So tan and cot has a reciprocal relationship. So these two ratios get cancelled out to give us 1. So we get 1 equal to h square by 36. So this implies h square is equal to 36. Taking square roots, we would get h equal to plus or minus 6. However, negative of height is not possible and hence h is equal to 6 meter. What we got to prove, and we have proved it.